I'm the chair of the Recreation Committee for the Golden Ring Foundation, and we formed a subcommittee to try to meet some of the needs of our shareholders. We think people would like to have a place to eat. We're thinking along the lines of a social hub. So let's say you have a friend come over and you're looking for a place to go. This will be a place where you can meet, have a cup of coffee, get a snack, or even a full dinner out of, believe it or not, vending machines. And they have come a very, very long way. The people who are responsible, who did the work on this subcommittee, were Paul Pratt, Linda Stone, and Bob Slater. And I think we owe them all a great deal of thanks. Linda did most of the design and planning, so the aesthetics will be, I think, better than what we usually see in some of our clubhouses. Paul did a tremendous amount of research on the vending machines, and we have an excellent vendor who will be with me today, and his name is George Sanchez, and we'll be speaking to him shortly. And Bob Slater has been an active member of this community for many, many years. And he had a tremendous amount of input because he goes to Hospitality Center regularly. And we wanted to make sure that somebody was involved with the committee who knows perhaps what the shareholders would like to have in some of the machines. So with that said, I would like to introduce George Sanchez and ask him some questions, because the vending machines of today are very different from the vending machines that you may have known from a long time ago, which were just candy bars and a Coke. So George, tell me, how are the vending machines different today than what we may have remembered, let's say, from the 1950s or the 1960s?
It's a good way to start. And thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to do what we're going to be doing. I think we're going to definitely meet or exceed your expectations. So on behalf of First Class Vending, my name is George Sanchez. And I'm one of the sales managers for the area for First Class, and I thank you and your committee for giving us the opportunity to embark on this venture, because I know it's been a long time since you had snack food and beverage or any kind of a cafe slash place to hang out, if you will. You know what, I'll tell you, the machines of today really haven't changed a whole lot, but I think what has happened is, or what has changed is the service, the product that does go in them, and the ability to make it user-friendly for employees and for the people like the tenants here at Leisure World to use. And when I say that, I mean, you know, adding probably the biggest thing that is new to vending is credit card readers. So you'll be able to access products, snack, food, and beverage with a swipe of a card, debit or Visa.
And may I say, just to interrupt for a second, that the food is delicious.
One of the things
that George did was to bring samples of the food to the committee, the subcommittee, and then later to the recreation committee. And we were absolutely impressed, and I personally vouch for the Santa Fe chicken salad. It is delicious.
We're gonna have to make sure we stock it on a daily basis. So yeah, that's good. That's good feedback. That's great to hear, and that's stuff that I could definitely take back to my boss, our regional manager, for sure.
Well, how does it actually work in terms of the money? I mean, do you put a dollar in, and if you buy something for 50 cents, get change back?
Correct, absolutely. Everything that you'll be working with from the standpoint of a snack, food, or beverage, or coffee, for that matter, it's dollar bills, it takes dollar bills, it takes change, coin, and it takes, of course, the credit card readers that I was just talking about. So if you do use coin or dollar bills, it will give you change, absolutely. So if a product is 75 cents and you put in a dollar, you can get a quarter back.
All right, so what happens if I put in a dollar and the machine eats my dollar?
Uh-oh, then we got an issue. We are 100% liable for that, and you will be refunded your money, absolutely. What we're going to be doing is setting up a bank for you, so you'll be having a monthly bank of about $15. As that goes down, or people do lose their money, because it does happen. Machines, unfortunately, are machines. They're not perfect. I wish I could say they're never going to break down, but I'd be lying if I said that. We fully refund your money. So as that goes down, your bank goes down. we'll replenish it and keep the $15 going. So that way nobody is out of their money for any long period of time.
Well, that's great. And something else I think our shareholders and members would love to know, and that is the cost of putting the vending machines in is zero for the foundation. We will also be getting a microwave courtesy of the vending company, and we will be receiving a 12% rebate on the gross for all the items that are not perishable. So this actually will be generating some revenue for the Golden Rain Foundation. The prices, I want to tell you, on the food are better than what you can get if you go to an outside fast food place. We will be starting with 50 cents for coffee. That's hard to beat. And the salad that I mentioned was $2.75. You cannot beat these prices, and I say the food is excellent. George, could you tell us exactly how these machines work? Do you need a pipeline, or do you need electric?
Yeah, it's a good question. The majority of the machines, out of the five different type of machines that we're going to be doing, that's including coffee, snack, food, and beverage, it's a fully electrical. So your 120 outlet will work, not a problem. The only one that does need a water line is your coffee. So for the obvious reasons, it has the coffee products in, do have to mix with the water line. So.
And will we have a variety of coffees so
Absolutely.
That you can have like French vanilla
Absolutely.
Or hazelnut? And what about tea?
Tea is available upon request. Normally it comes with the different varieties of coffees. You'll have flavors, and you'll also have your cafe lattes, if you will, your frappuccinos, cappuccinos.
Ah, everybody wants those.
Sure. And of course, hot chocolate. So.
All
Especially
right, and how about macaroni and cheese?
Macaroni and cheese out of the food machine? Absolutely.
All
that
right.
Is scary.
All
Absolutely.
Right. I want to mention that the location of the cafe will be in Clubhouse 5. If you go into the clubhouse either through the front door or through the side patio, you will be able to reach the cafe. There will be tables and chairs. We expect that it will be fully able to seat about 20 people. And then there's an outside patio where there's also seating. So in the good weather, you can get your cafe latte and sit outside and under the umbrella and enjoy it. And we want this to be a place where it's not only that food is available and beverage is available, but it's also a place to meet your friends, to socialize, to find out what's going on in the community. And that is the intention of this. And we really hope that you will support the cafe. It will be good for you. It will be good for the foundation. I think you will really be impressed by the food products. And we also need to hear back from you as to what you would like. If there is a food item in particular that you would like to see, I think, George, you would be receptive to some input.
Sure. Absolutely. On the snack, the beverage products that are, we have a very wide variety, so absolutely any feedback is always welcome.
Is there anything else that you think that we need to know?
Let me think here. I think the biggest thing is looking forward to it, looking forward to becoming partners and getting it installed. And definitely getting some feedback, because obviously the real feedback comes once we're up and running. Different feedback from the tenants that are here, and to see how successful or if there's anything that we need to tweak. Because
my understanding was that you would actually be looking at the machines maybe every day, like the first
Probably
2 weeks?
On a weekly basis, absolutely.
And another concern that some of our shareholders have had is the freshness mm-hmm. of the food. And please tell me whether these are dated and how often you might be looking to see whether
question.
They need to be replaced.
Yeah. Absolutely. Obviously, we wouldn't be in business if we were selling product that was not fresh or up to speed, and it's a great way to start, because with fresh food you do have to be very careful, very perishable. So nothing is in the machines more than 4 to 5 days. They're rotated out. If something's not moving, we look for a better product to put in there or some variety. So you're not going to have anything that is going to be outdated. It is dated. Everything is dated. So part of our job, part of our rep man's job, is to ensure that that freshness is consistent. Obviously, you can't have anything in there that is going to be going bad because, well, for the obvious reasons, nobody's going to be happy with that. We won't as a company, and obviously the tenants here at Leisure World won't be happy. So great question. It is dated, and that's on the fresh food. On the snacks, you got a little bit of more of a shelf life, a little bit of leeway. It's about 2 weeks. But it is, again, everything is dated, so you don't run across outdated product because it's not going to sell and it's not going to keep our clients happy. So,
all right. Now,
beverages as well.
I did hear something about nitrogen, that it's nitrogen packed. Is that correct?
Nitrogen packed would be some products, and that's mainly in the Aquafina, Dasani, the water.
I see.
Your purified water. So that is nitrogen packed, and that, there's a reason for that. It's one, for freshness; two, to keep the bottle hard. So when it vents, you're not getting a flat bottle or a product that's inferior.
All right. Well, I am really looking forward to the opening of the cafe. I think you'd like to know, when is the cafe going to be open? Not only an opening date, which I can't give you exactly, but the hours of operation. The cafe will be open from 7 o'clock in the morning until 9 o'clock at night. And for your security, there will be someone in the building, and there also will be regular maintenance taking place. I don't have an exact date yet as to when it will open. However, I am believing that we will have an opening day ceremony, and you will hear about it. It will certainly be in the Golden Rain News, and we really look forward to every shareholder coming by and supporting it. And I hope that our efforts to bring this to you will be something that will be a real asset to this community. And I thank you very much for your support. And the Recreation Committee has done a wonderful job of looking into this, and I'm very proud of all the people that have participated on the committee. And I also owe a special thanks to Mario Michaelides, who is the president of the Golden Rain Foundation, and Randy Ankeny assisted with much of the work, as did Terry DeLeon. And I wish you well, and I will look forward to having a cup of coffee with you.